So now in our electronic circuit analysis lab, the first experiment is the frequency response of common emitter amplifier. Frequency response of common emitter amplifier. So for every experiment we will have aim, apparatus, procedure, circuit diagram, tabular columns, model graphs and result. So now first we will see the aim of this experiment. Aim: to plot the frequency response of BJT amplifier in common emitter configuration. Right, this is our aim. In this we have to find the maximum gain in dB and calculate bandwidth. These things you have to do, right? So this is our aim. Now we will go to apparatus. DC regulated power supply BC 107 transistor, 1 in number, right, and 10 microfarads and 1 microfarad capacitors, 2 in number, and we have resistors of 1 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm, 100 kilo ohm, 4.7 kilo ohm. All these resistors. And 4 millihenry, and we have function generator, 1 megahertz function generator. CRO and connecting wires. These are the major equipment what we require to perform this common emitter amplifier. Common emitter amplifier, right? So now we will go to the procedure. Connect the circuit diagram as shown in the figure adjust the input signal with the function generator by giving the input signal that is of 50 millivolts V peak to peak, right? Now vary this input signal in steps from 20 hertz to 1 megahertz and note down the corresponding output voltage on CRO. On CRO, right? So 20 hertz to 1 megahertz. This is important. For these values, we need to draw the graph. Clear? So now we will look into the circuit diagram. So now this is the CE amplifier and it follows the self-bias circuit, right? Because it has the good stability. Take a BC107. Connect a resistance at the emitter and connect a capacitance in parallel to this emitter. Ground the emitter. This is called as RE as you are connecting at the emitter. This is called as CE. This is 10 microfarads and this is 2.2 kilo ohms. Right? And now here we have to connect a collector resistance RC. This is of 10 kilo ohms. This is VCC, 12 volts. Connect a coupling capacitor CC here of 1 microfarad. Here we will be connecting the CRO and collect the output. Now, here I am connecting a biasing resistances R1 and R2. This is 47 kilo ohms and this is 4.7 kilo ohms. Now, take a connection from here. Here it should be a nodal point, then only the parallel combination will be achieved. So connect a capacitor here at the input C1. This is of 1 microfarad to this. Connect the input voltage, AC voltage. Vin, right? So this is 50 millivolts peak to peak. 50 millivolts peak to peak. This is AC. Clear? So now here, when you give this, this is passed through this capacitor to check whether any DC is present here. That DC is blocked with this capacitance, and then this is given to the base of the transistor, Due to the transistor action, the input is amplified and given at the RC as IC. The product of IC RC is collected as Vo. Right, so this is the circuit diagram of your common emitter amplifier. Now we should see the frequency response. For that, right, take a tabular column consisting of serial number 1, 2, how many readings you want to take till there, frequency here, frequency from 20 hertz, 50 hertz, 100 hertz, 200 hertz, like this in steps, right? 1K, 2K, 10K, 20K, 100K, 1 mega. Like this, you have to take in a steps. Then for this particular frequency, what is the output voltage you should calculate from CRO? Output voltage Vo. Then gain AV is equals to Vo by VI. Where is VI? VI is a constant which you have maintained in your experiment. That is, VI is equals to 50 millivolts. This is your VI. So Vo by VI, right? VI is constant for all. Now, gain in dB. This is given by 20 log AV. Whatever the AV value you are getting here, that should be made into logarithmic by 20 log AV. Now you will get the particular values here in dB. For these values, we have to draw the graph. Especially in the case of our amplifiers, always we draw the graph on semi-log sheet, because semi-log, half logarithmic one, means your frequencies are in normal values and gains are in logarithmic values. Therefore, we are using the semi-log graph. So now, first we will see the model graph, how actually it will look, and then we will plot the graph. Consider y-axis, consider x-axis, gain in dB is taken on y-axis, frequency is taken on x-axis, right? So now when we plot the graph, the graph will look like this. Right? So now if you see here in the graph, this area is constant. This gain is called as maximum gain in dB. Right? So all your values are in dB now. Gain values are in dB here on y-axis. So now Here, whatever the value you are getting as the maximum gain, value you are getting as a maximum gain, from that you have to subtract 3 dB. That is known as minus 3 dB. Example, if maximum gain is 41, then minus 3 dB will be equal to 38. So your maximum gain is 41, this one, at 38. 38 means 41 kinda. So here it is 38. Here you have to draw a parallel line to the x-axis. This x-axis is meeting the graph, this curve, at two points. I have mentioned those two points. From there, you drop the perpendiculars to the x-axis. The first one is called as F1, or lower cutoff frequency, and the second one is called as F2, the upper cutoff frequency. Therefore, our bandwidth is equals to F2 minus F1. F2 minus F1. This is how you calculate bandwidth. And here you have the, in the values, you have the maximum gain. Which one is very high, that one you take it as a maximum gain. This is how we draw the graph. This is the modal graph. Right? Now, we will look into the result part. What actually? Always, result should be opposite to the aim. Result should be always opposite to the aim. What did you written in the aim? To plot the frequency response of the BJT in common emitter configuration. So in the result, what we will write? Frequency response of common emitter amplifier is studied or plotted, in you can write, right? And in the result only, maximum gain in dB, we have to write the value, right? Bandwidth at the well. This is your result. Clear? So now we will plot the graph by taking the semi-log sheet. Frequency response of CE amplifier. So now, amplifier is a circuit which strengthens the weak signal. So here in the practical part, what we are doing is, for different frequencies, what is the gain we are checking, and we are plotting the graph for that. So now, our aim, the common emitter amplifier and study the frequency response. That's what. We will design the common emitter amplifier, means we will design the R1, R2, R3 values, and then here we study the response for various frequencies. What is the gain of this common emitter amplifier is studied here. This is the aim. Now, apparatus required. Breadboard, RPS, bipolar junction transistor BJT BC107,
resistors 2.k, 3.3k, 33k, 4.7k, 470 ohms and 10 microfarad capacitors 2 and 100 microfarad capacitor 1. Connecting wires. Function generator to generate the input sine wave, CRO to check the output waveform in the cathode ray oscilloscope. Now I will show you the connections. Here we are doing the common emitter amplifier. Common emitter means the emitter terminal is made common for both input as well as output. Circuit diagram. So common emitter, emitter I have grounded. So now this is the biasing circuit R1, R2 and R3. RE and CE is the low bypass circuit which offers a low feedback network. So now this is the RC, here RC having of 3.3k ohms. Now here from RC we have connected a 10 microfarads capacitor. Across this capacitor we will take the output. The input 50 millivolts peak to peak is given from function generator with 1 kilohertz. And this is connected to the 1 kilo ohm one end resistor. The resistor other end is given to the positive of the capacitor. The negative of the capacitor is connected to the base of the transistor. Now emitter, as it is a common emitter, emitter is grounded. Now I will show these connections on the breadboard. So I have placed the transistor base emitter collector. Base here, emitter is top one and collector is here. Emitter, base, collector. These are the grounds and this is for the power supply. This is for the power supply and these are the grounds. Sorry, this is the ground and these are the power supplies. I have grounded the emitter terminal. If you see from here, I have taken a resistor, this one RE, from emitter to ground. So RE from emitter to the ground I have given. CE 100 microfarads from emitter to the ground I have given. Right. So now R1 33K is given from emitter to the supply. And here from the base, see if you see here R1 is from base to ground and from base to power supply. This is R2 here, R1 is here. Now RE I have explained you, RC the collector resistance, here from the collector it is given to the supply. Once again I will explain you, emitter, base, collector. From emitter RE is this one and CE is this one. From the base here R1 and R2 here, right? And RC, this is the RC and this is the output capacitor which is coming from collector. One end I have placed at the collector and another end I have kept in the breadboard, from where I have taken the output which is connected to the CRO. Now how to give the input? Connect the probe to the function generator. From the function generator positive you connect a wire and for the negative you connect a wire, and here you at the positive should go to the resistor one end and negative should go to the ground. So now I will show you the input wave in the CRO. I have to maintain 50 millivolts. So in the knob 50, I have kept at the 50 millivolts and one unit I will maintain here. So now I am showing you the graph of the input. See here, one unit into 50 millivolts, one unit into 50 millivolts is my input. So now I have checked it and I have connected to the resistor one end. The negative of this is given to the ground. So now due to the transistor and this biasing network, it will be amplified and given at the output capacitor. So to check this output, I have connected a CRO channel probe to the capacitor one end and the negative is connected to the ground. So now here I will check the frequency response, that is for various frequencies I will change the frequencies in this function generator and I will check the output here, output voltage here, and then I will calculate the response. So initially I kept 1 unit into 50 millivolts and 1 kilohertz by varying the frequency knob, 1 kilohertz by varying the frequency knob. So 1 kilohertz and 50 millivolts is maintained. Now from 20 hertz to 1 megahertz, I will vary the frequency and I will check the output voltage. So now adjust the knob to the 1 volt for easy calculation, or 2 volts, right? 1 or 2 volts. Now vary the frequency from 20 hertz to 20 hertz, what is the output? At the 20 hertz, we will have the disturbance. So adjust the time period and check this one. So it is now 0.2 into 2, and at 50 hertz, at 50 hertz it is 0.4 into 2, at 100 hertz 0.6 into 2, 300 hertz 0.8 into 2, for 500 it is 1.2 into 2, for 1000, that is 1 kilo, it is, now we can see the amplification here, adjust the time period knob, it is 1.8 into 2, and for 2k it is 2.2 into 2. From like this we have to take, for 2k you notice the read 2.2 into 2, like that 3k, 5k, like this for various frequencies of 1 mega we have to take the V naught. Then we will calculate the AV taking V naught by VI. The input VI is equals to 50 millivolts here. So V naught by, this is our V naught and this is our VI. We will get various AV. Now we will calculate the gain in dB. dB is equals to 20 log AV, that is V naught by VI. We will get the values. For that we have to draw the graphs, like how we will show in the model graph. Now I will show you the model graph here, model graph. So now for this, take the semi-log graph. For all the amplifiers you have to take the semi-log graphs, because your gain is in the logarithmic value. So now take a semi-log graph, take y-axis, take x-axis. Always frequency is considered on x-axis and gain in dB is considered in y-axis. So now this dB, AV in dB is equals to 20 log AV. So now here the initially the gain will increase. At certain frequency the gain will become constant, and afterwards the gain will decrease. That is, the frequency, the gain where it is increasing, they are called as low frequencies. The gain where it is constant, it is called as mid frequencies, and the gain where it is decreasing is called as high frequencies. Now at the minus 3 dB of the maximum gain, we draw a parallel line to the x-axis at minus 3 dB of the maximum gain. Now it is meeting the graph at 2 points. From there, drop the perpendiculars to the x-axis. This one is considered as F1 and this one is considered as F2. So now here we calculate the bandwidth. The bandwidth is given as F2 minus F1. So here you substitute the values of F2 and F1, you will get the bandwidth from the graph. Now I
So now how to draw the frequency response curve for common emitter amplifier we will see. So this is the similar graph here. So on y-axis, you consider on y-axis, this is your y-axis, the vertical one, and the horizontal, you can see the numbers here, 1, 2, 3, this is your x-axis. Frequencies are considered on x-axis, and gain in dB, gain in dB is considered on y-axis, right? So now, how to take the scale and things we will explain. On x-axis, this from 1 to 10, this is considered into 10. This is considered into 10 to the power of, this is 1, this is 10 to the power of 2, this is into 10 to the power of 3, into 10 to the power of 4, into 10 to the power of 5. This last one is 10 to the power of 6, that is 1 megahertz. So now how to consider means 1 into 10, 10, 2 into 10, 20, like this, 10 into 10, 100. So now here this is 200, 300, 400, 500, so on 1K, 2K, 3K, 4K, 5K, 6K, 10K, 20K, 30K, like that, 100K, 200K, 300K, 400K, last one is 1 mega. So these are the frequencies. And now we have to take the gains on the x-axis. So now I will put the x-axis in a dark color for you. Right, you can see the y-axis now here. So now let us take the values of the common emitter amplifier. Common emitter amplifier, you have taken the values for common emitter amplifier frequency starting from 20 hertz to 1 megahertz. 20 hertz to 1 megahertz. So now here for 20 hertz, how much value you have? Like this, you. Now, what is the gain? The minimum gain. The minimum gain what I have here is, the minimum gain what I have here is 20, and the maximum gain what I have is 45. So now, according to that, I have to set the scale. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 is enough for me, because my maximum gain in decibels is 45. So now for 20 hertz, where is the 20 hertz? 2 into 10, this is the 20 hertz. So travel like this in straight line. For 20 hertz, I got the gain as 20. You may get another value. This is the example, the values of the experiment done by me. I am showing on the similar graph, right? Then for 50 hertz,
For 50 hertz, it is 28. So 20 and 30 here, the half of the 20 and 30 is 25 here, and now 25 above that 3 for 50 hertz. For 100 hertz, it is 31, 30 and go on, 31, right? For 300, it is 33 here. For 500, it is 35 here. For 1K, it is 40. And for 2K, it is 44. For 3K, 44. For 4K, 44. For 5K, 44. Like this, till 100K, I got the same gain. After this, my gain starts decreasing. So for 200K, it is 40. And for 400K, it is 38. And for 600K, it is 35. And for 1 mega, again, it is 0. So now, how to join these? So this should be a freehand drawing. And you should not join all the dots which is mentioned on the graph sheet, because it may take another shape. First, you have to look your model graph, right? In the same way, you have to join the dots, and it should be a freehand drawing. In this procedure, you may leave certain points. It is not any absurd or it's not a problem for us. So now here, now I start joining these points slowly. As I'm showing on the digital pad, it may not be so appropriate. Please bear with me. Now I left some 5 to 6 points. No problem. That is why we are taking these many values. Right? Slowly join this curve like this. And is the shape of your frequency response of the common emitter amplifier. This is the maximum gain in dB. That is 44, right? So to calculate the bandwidth, we have to consider the gain at minus 3 dB of maximum gain. So 44 minus 3 is 41 around here. Now at 41, you draw a horizontal line which is parallel to the x-axis. Now this horizontal line will cut the graph at 2 points, right? From there, you drop the perpendicular to the x-axis. So this is your lower cutoff frequency F1, and this is the upper cutoff frequency F2. So now my bandwidth is equals to F2 minus F1. So now we have to calculate the F2 and F1 values. This is F1, project like this upwards, and it is meeting 8. Therefore, F1 is equals to 80 hertz. Project like this, this is 100K. 1 into 10 to the power of 5 means 100K. F2 is equals to 100K. So, therefore, bandwidth is equals to 100,000 minus 80. 100,000 minus 80 is the bandwidth, which is equals to 99,920. So bandwidth is equals to 99.9 kilohertz. This is how we calculate the bandwidth for an amplifier. So in your result, if you are asked that to fill the maximum gain in dB, the maximum gain in dB is the 44 and bandwidth is 99.9. So this is how we do the frequency response curve for any amplifier. This is for the common emitter amplifier, but for any amplifier you can draw the graph like this only.